Welcome! In this quick tutorial, you'll learn how to get started with the Unipile API and send your first message in just a few minutes. Unipile is an innovative API designed to seamlessly integrate messaging, email, and social platforms into your application. After signing up, you'll land in the Accounts section of the dashboard. In Unipile, accounts refer to provider accounts, such as LinkedIn, Google, or Outlook, not to be confused with your Unipile admin account. To perform actions and access data from a specific provider account, it must first be connected to Unipile. Connecting authorizes Unipile to access the account's data on behalf of the account owner. Click Connect an account, select a provider, and authenticate with the account you want to send message from. You can also connect accounts programmatically from within your application, but we won't cover that in this quick start guide. Once connected, the account should appear in the list as running. Now, one key thing to understand is that every provider API in Unipile consists of two components, methods and real-time. Methods are RESTful API endpoints that let you read, write, and update various types of resources from the provider. You can explore all available endpoints in the API reference. Realtime refers to webhooks. Unipile uses them to notify your application about events happening on accounts in real-time or nearly. These events can include the creation, updates, or deletion of resources such as new messages, or behaviors like messages read receipts. In this quick start, we'll focus on methods only. Unipile organizes its methods API into distinct subgroups based on the features offered by each provider. Each group is designed to handle a specific set of resources. For example, under the messaging section, you'll find endpoints for messaging providers with resources such as chats, messages and groups, which is exactly what we need for our LinkedIn account. In this video, I'm going to use Postman to build and demonstrate requests. It's a free tool that makes it easy to test and explore APIs. Now, let's say you want to send a message in an existing chat. First, you need to get that chat identifier by listing all available chats. Let's do that. Go to the API reference and copy the endpoint URL. There are two things to keep in mind when making a request. All requests must use your DSN as the base URL. You'll find your DSN in the dashboard. If you're using the Node.js SDK, you'll need to specify it when creating the client. But here, I'll simply copy it and replace the default base URL in the documentation. Second, all requests must be authenticated using an access token. To get one, go to the access token section in the dashboard. Click Generate Token, give it a name, select the messaging scope and click Generate. Make sure to keep this token secret. Now it should be added to the X API key header in each request. Now that everything is set, you can send the request to list all chats and retrieve their identifiers. Pick the one you want to use and keep it handy. To send a message in that chat, use the Send a message in a chat endpoint. Copy the path, change the method to post, and pass the chat ID where needed. In the request body, specify the message content in a JSON object like this. Send the request, and just like that, you should see the message appear in LinkedIn. And what's amazing about Unipile is that you learn once and integrate with every provider. You can reuse the same methods with accounts from other providers that support messaging features, like WhatsApp or Telegram. Head over to the documentation to learn how to connect account programmatically, set up webhooks, and much more.